Hey guys, what's going on? It's Thursday morning, 8 a.m. Before I get in this video, make sure you like, subscribe, comment below. This is a stock I am super, super, super interested. Almost pulled the trigger yesterday when it IPO'd, but I got cold feet, got busy at work, and was super, super, super indecisive. So as I talk about this video, if anything comes up in the comments, I would love to hear you guys' input on this. This is a space I'm not in currently, and I'm having a super, super, super hard time really evaluating it. So if you're like really in the cryptos or you're in this stock, comment below and let me know why you're in it and where you think it's gonna go in a long-term perspective. So not really interested in the short-term perspective. I think it's gonna run up, it's gonna be really volatile. We all know that's gonna happen, but I'd be really interested in hearing long-term investors' opinions on this space. Again, I'm not in this space, but I'm really interested and I'm just having a hard time really putting an evaluation of where I think this company's going. So with that said, obviously Coinbase is the company, ticker is COIN, which I love. It's super easy to find. I feel like that is gonna make people buy the stock just because there are a lot of investors out there that don't do their due diligence in researching companies or like, Bitcoin or crypto, well, it's a coin. So they're gonna type coin into the keyword search. And I think those people are gonna see, you know, Coinbase and be like, oh, this is crypto, I'm buying it. So it's weird marketing, but I feel like that simple ticker is gonna bring added value to the stock. It's weird. I really think that's a thing. It's more of us a marketing thing, but I really do feel like that works. When you have confusing tickers, it's hard to find sometimes, or people will give up, or people that are newer in the market, they just won't understand how to get to it, but I feel like that's a great ticker. So I love that. So that's a plus. It IPO'd yesterday around 1 p.m. Eastern time. I believe it was like 1:30, 1 p.m. It reached highs yesterday at 420. So that's they said it was going to IPO at 250. So that's crazy. So it reached highs of 420 and it ended yesterday at 338.25. Obviously, you know, I had numbers ran and, you know, I was just so indecisive of where I wanted to do. I'm not in the crypto space at all. So this is something I'm willing to tinker with basically. So I like being diversified. I like having two of everything, like two EV, two restaurant, two hotel, two e-com. Like I like doing things in twos. And MJ, I have three, but that's because I feel like there's a lot of opportunity in that market, but in the future. So this is a space I definitely want to get into because I feel like this is also the future. So obviously it's going to be super volatile. We saw massive swings throughout the day, like, you know, 20, 30% swings from open to midday to close. It was going nuts. And I feel like it's going to continue to do that for the next couple weeks or months. So I feel like I didn't miss an opportunity. Obviously, it went down, it didn't run up like the 500, 600, 700, 800. Then I would have been like, okay, maybe I missed the opportunity. Not interested, market cap's way too high. Too unpredictable, too risky, out. But being the fact that it went down, I'm very interested in it. So like I just said, very hard to evaluate. If you guys in the that watch this video, if you guys understand crypto and Coinbase and, you know, all that, if you could just in the comments below write something and explain to me why I should be buying the stock right now and how you guys evaluate this company, I would love to know. Because I can't reference anything because obviously it's a new thing. And, you know, obviously if Bitcoin goes from 60,000 to 30,000 or corrects 50%, goes down to 40,000, this stock's obviously gonna go down, or, you know, organically, just because people are gonna be like, well, Bitcoin's going away. And, you know, it could be happening like what happened in 2017. And that's where I'm kind of hesitant on buying it right now, because Bitcoin's at all-time highs, the markets are at all-time highs, there's tons of money everywhere flooded around, and you got, you know, option traders, you got short-term traders, you got people that want to get in and out of stocks in a day. Like, you know, and this is on everyone's radar right now, obviously. Like, if you follow the market, this is probably somewhere on your top page of whatever you go on. So I just want to make sure I'm investing in the right thing at the right time as best as I can do. And I just don't feel confident enough at this second. I might make a small position tomorrow and I'll put, you know, here where I like, love, and hold. this is based on like my numbers and where I see it going long term in the future. I do believe in crypto. I do, but I don't know if Bitcoin will be always the number one player or be the best currency in 5 years. But I do believe there will be some form of crypto, and it will be more readily accepted everywhere. I do believe that. So that's why I want to get in this. Will I start a position? I obviously just said yes. I do want to start a position, but if it runs up to like 500, 600, 700, 800 tomorrow, I'm not starting a position, especially at that price. The market cap would be insane. So where do I love this stock? Honestly, I like it anywhere, obviously at the 250. I don't think it's going to go below 250. I really don't. Unless Bitcoin just has a massive sell-off and people panic and there's bad news that comes out. But I don't think that's going to happen. So 250 to 300, I love. Like, that's kind of where I want to start my position, because even if it does go to 250, 200, which I don't think it's going to do, I'll average cost down and drive it down to 250 or, you know, whatever it is at that time if I buy around 300. So that's kind of where I love it. Like 325 to 400, I think, is still a good buy. I am very cash heavy right now. If you've watched my previous videos, I hold a decent, you know, like close to 28, 26% at this point. So I do have the cash to kind of build a position. It's not like I'm cash strapped right now. So maybe I'll just start a position. And then obviously anything, you know, 425 plus, I'm really not buying it. I don't even want to get in at this point. There's too much uncertainty. The earnings is ridiculous in this company. They're profitable. They do charge a heavy fee for every transaction you do. I think they're going to have to move that back and down in the future, which is going to hurt earnings, obviously. So just got to keep that in mind. You know, a lot of things, it's a very risky stock, but it also is a big, it's like a big market cap. You know, I think it's $65 billion. Like, that is not a small market. Like, this is not like under a $10 billion company. This is a big company. So, which is good, because I think they, you know, when they're, if they're cash, if they're making profits, that gives them money to invest, link up with people, expand. It's good. It's just, what do you do? You know? So if you guys have opinions on where you'd buy, where you'd hold, obviously I'm a long-term investor, so I'm not looking to do like, oh, buy it at 350 and then get out at 400. Like, I'm not doing, like, that's not my style of investing. But yeah, so it's at 338.25. So it's right in that like still buy area in my eyes. If it goes down to like this, I have to buy. If it stays at this tomorrow, maybe I'll buy. If it goes this, I'm not buying. That's for tomorrow. But yeah, so let me know your guys' thoughts below. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment below. Really trying to get to 500 subs by the end of the month. Don't know if it's possible, but maybe it is. So if you just hit that subscribe button, it helps me out. And peace.